The good,
the bad,
and the gossip.
These are the Fitz Files.
So Fox is poking fun at all the TV show revivals with a brand new show about an old show that's being revived. It's about a former child star who sucked back into his old show with his old TV family.
Oh.
Cool.
Really?
It's bizarre, isn't it?
I like it.
So they're making a TV show kind of about a TV show?
I guess. About
meta.
There is no word on any casting yet. You know, I've always been really interested in, like, you know, childhood stars and what happens in their adult life. It's, I mean, because a lot of times it doesn't end up too well. And I guess it's because, you know, I guess they weren't told enough in life that fame is fleeting. Do you know what? When I started out in radio and I, you know, maybe working in some big cities, yeah, I've worked in some big radio markets, big cities in our country. And my dad would always say to me, he'd be like, fame is fleeting. He said, this is all good. And he goes, I hope you love this. But he goes, I want you to know that it's not going to last forever. Be prepared.
Yeah.
Right? And so I've always said that to myself. Fame is fleeting. So when I have bad times in the entertainment industry, hopefully I'm mentally prepared for it. But for some reason, a lot of childhood stars, they can't get there.
I think fame, unlike other forms of success, is often dictated not by what you do or how you perform. Sometimes it's completely externalized. So
and time, it's about
turn, their industry can turn their back on you.
Completely about timing, right?
Yeah. Right.
Yeah.
Just
so
like that.
You may be doing exactly what you used to do, and suddenly you're not desired. You're not wanted. You're not on the list.
All right. Ted Nugent says that Kid Rock is not running for Senate.
What?
He says some goofball in the Michigan GOP just pulled it out of their butt. Kid Rock's rocking and rolling, man. He's touring, man. He's writing songs, recording. He's got a full-time job, and he's a great man, but he is not running for Senate. So if Ted Nugent says that, is it true? Is Kid Rock
I just did a news story earlier that Kid Rock had petitioned the Michigan State Senate to determine if he could run under the name Kid Rock or under Robert Ritchie, his real name.
You did say that, Drew.
Right. Also, so now I don't know who to believe.
Ted Nugent has been very involved in politics lately.
Well, he always is.
Ted Nugent has been involved in politics his entire life.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. Ted Nugent.
The Motor City Madman?
Yeah, the Motor City Madman.
That's Ted Nugent, man. You better get on it, Tanner. Hey, by the way, everybody, Tanner the Millennial broke his arm just a couple of days ago. He's in a lot of pain. His fingers are swelling in a bizarre way.
They look like sausages.
Yeah, they do. Little piglets, to be honest with you.
Yeah, I can't move them.
Well, that could be an issue.
Just a little one.
I thought this was interesting. Robin Thicke, you know, the guy who sings that song. Bloodline. You know that one? His 22-year-old girlfriend, April Love Geary, they're expecting a baby on March 1st.
He has a 22-year-old girlfriend?
Wow.
That was
quick. He's an older dude.
He just got divorced, didn't he, from Paula Patton?
Yeah.
Very recently.
Paula Patton's beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
What is up with you, Robin
Thicke?
She
didn't have very beautiful things to say about him.
Well,
it was a nasty divorce. She implied a lot of, or it basically came out and said there was abuse and all these other problems, and it was like a nuclear option.
He
divorce.
Is almost double her age. He's
Gross.
40 years old.
What are you trying to say?
Maybe I shouldn't say
that. Yeah, what's wrong with that?
He sings that beautiful song. Bloodline.
Okay, that brings up a great thing. Do you think that that's appropriate or do you not think it's appropriate for people to date people that could be their dad or their child?
Ladies like older guys. It's just, it's science.
Yeah.
Okay, whatever.
Science.
All right, there you go. You got the good, the bad, and the gossip. You got the Fitz Files.
The conversations we have are just like the ones you have. It's the Fitz Show.